Paris, to me, is like jazz. Unpredictable, elegant, and best when it's cool.
You know, there really is nothing like Paris in the wintertime. It is spectacular. There aren't the big crowds. It is a little chilly, so you get to break out a coat. But more importantly, you get to see the real Parisians.
I love Paris, but if this is all you see of Paris, then you're really not experiencing Paris. You're sleeping through some of the best parts. Welcome to Little Africa. I've never been to a market in Accra, but I'm sure this is kind of what it feels like. Chateau Rouge is the neighborhood, and it has been likened to Harlem, and I get the reference because in both places, the people are black, but this is as close as you will get to visiting Africa without actually going to Africa. Paris has the largest population of Africans in Europe, and that's because the goods and the people of Africa helped fuel France's global ambitions for centuries. And we still see the remnants of that colonial period today. That's how you end up winning the World Cup with guys named Mbappe, Pogba, Umtiti. It's also why the immigrants from Africa who now live in and around Paris flock to Little Africa. So here's the deal. Hop on the underground and ride to Chateau Rouge. You'll know you're headed the right way because the faces on the subway become very African very quickly. The sights, the sounds, and the food are nothing short of spectacular and authentic. There's no concierge who speaks English, so directions and communicating can be a challenge. So if you want to, you can book a tour. There are several. Just make sure that once you are done with the Louvre, the Eiffel Tower, and Versailles, head to Little Africa and embrace another part of the city's magic.